piece about an anniversary of the TV show Play School over on the ABC. And Courtney Act, well-known drag performer from, 20 years ago on Australian Idol, well, was invited on to read a story to kids.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Storytime. My name is Courtney, and this is Humpty. Hi. We are going to read you a story. I wonder what the story will be about today, Humpty. Oh, did you hear that? That was the sound of the magic story drawer.
A conventional kid's story, right? But apparently the controversy here, there you go, trying to pronounce it properly, but I had to go bogan, is that Courtney Act was invited at all. This is what took up the time in Canberra today.
And at the moment, the ABC is airing a program called Courtney Act, The Spectacular Suit, in which a male drag performer, Shane Jenick, reads a children's book called The Spectacular Suit, says it here, about a female child wanting to wear male clothing. The program was rated G. And it's been heavily promoted on TV and on the app. My question is this. Why is the ABC grooming Australian children with this sort of adult content?
Senator, I don't see that as grooming children with that content. That particular program is reading from a book that's about dressing up.
So grooming is a really serious matter. It's not for being played with by conservative senators so they can make headlines.
Now, Nick, I'm all up for a culture war, but I'm not entirely sure play school's the word. Line in the sand here. What a weird day in Canberra today.
Definitely a weird day, and Senator Alex Antic there takes a cake. I mean, that is disgraceful what he was doing there. I mean, Australians come in all shapes and sizes, including drag queens. I think most of us are pretty comfortable with having drag queen read a children's story. It's part of a performance. I think it's totally fine, and that was an absolutely shameful effort by him. I really think he should be sanctioned in some way for such a disgraceful performance.
So, I mean, Bronwyn, you became nationwide famous for how you behave in these things, and basically it's an opportunity for you to line people up and bang, go get them, right? To me, there are plenty of things about the ABC you can have a whack at before you start getting to these.
Well, estimates are a wonderful opportunity for a senator to oversight the entire spending of the budget in various groups and various committees. But it is an opportunity to hold the government to account for that expenditure. And I certainly did it over the years, everything from getting a $20 million payout for people who'd been wrongly dealt with to finding a criminal who was getting a boat bounty from the Australian public. It's an opportunity for those things. But the questions that was asked by Alex Antic is a legitimate question, I suppose.
Not groovy, no.
But the answers weren't helpful either. We had grandstanding from Senator Hanson Young, and we had obfuscation from Mr. Anderson. So I don't know what that book is, but I do know that people who are drag queens in our community are part of our community. They're individuals who are terrific people who go about their lives with integrity. They're not about dressing up, they're about being who they are. It's integral to their personality. So I just think that sometimes I think the ABC just contrives to make controversy.
But also, look,
Folks, you've seen now the next step, which is the acceptance of abnormalcy, at least in Australia, certainly here it looks like. And you can now see that to even question what is happening is going to be completely out of bounds, and it's not going to be tolerated. In my opinion now, the Australians, not all of them, of course, we have people that are going to fight this, but they're not going to be many, I don't believe. This is being pushed very heavily. Australia has now turned to the dark side, is what it looks like to me. Take care, folks.